Late last year, the Workers' Party CEC set up the WP60 committee to commemorate the 60th anniversary of the party. 60 years is a long time in the history of any political party. The biggest issue for the WP60 committee was how to capture the memories and footsteps of the party in an appropriate and meaningful manner, but yet without embellishing difficult moments. With this in mind, we quickly set about our task and resolved to give the various subcommittees and task groups as much latitude as possible in determining how they wish to proceed. I have spoken about the various activities that were conducted over the course of the WP60 celebrations during the official opening of the WPHQ on the 29th of September this year. These included organising a community walk, reaching out to less fortunate Singaporeans, hosting a WP60 exhibition and National Day dinner, and publishing a commemorative book, which I will leave Daniel to speak about later. Rather than go into each of these activities, which many of you here today experienced and wholeheartedly supported, something the party is very grateful for, I want to share my thoughts on the party's road to WP60 and the stories of some individuals who made that possible. WP60 is also about these individuals, no matter how small a role they played, all of whom are individual parts of a jigsaw that has made the Workers' Party what it is today. Without them, the jigsaw would be incomplete, and strikingly so. Shortly after David Marshall left the party in the early 1960s, the party went into limbo until it was revived by Mr. J.B. Jayaratnam in the early 1970s. Two men endeavoured to keep it alive as an ongoing concern. They were humble pastry chefs. One was Lim Yi Ping, who we are honoured to have with us today. And the other was Chiang Seok-kyung. I can only imagine the expressions of futility many must have hosted for such a small political party in Singapore's political landscape. But without the efforts of these two pastry chefs to keep the Workers' Party alive, the party may have well ceased to exist much earlier. When I joined the party in 2010, I came to know of a small group of newer and younger members who exhibited tremendous initiative and enthusiasm in organizing activities for the party. They included Ng Swee Bee, Lee Li Lian, Kenneth Fu, Melvin Tan, Ko Chun Yong, Titi Tan, and Chelsea Liu. These individuals, and many like them, too numerous to name here, including volunteers and well-wishers, worked quietly behind the scenes, living up to the saying, talk less, do more. They were not shy of hard and unglamorous work and quietly slogged in the interests of the party, not their own personal interests or vain glory. As a rookie political candidate during the 2011 general elections, I got to know a warhorse, Jane Leong, who pulled the strings mustering candidates and ensuring the smooth running of election rallies. I did not have much contact with her then, but she had this steel about her, and whenever candidates would get ready to go behind the rostrum, her eyes would transmit a call to be calm, steady, and confident, and to ace the moment. Jane sadly passed away from cancer a few months ago. Before he became an MP in sometime around 2010, my colleague Faizal Manap was given a choice by his employers just 2 days before the CEC elections. Decide whether you want to continue with your political activism or if you want to keep your job. Faizal had three very young children at that time. When our first Prime Minister, Mr. Lee Kuan Yew, spoke about his entry into politics, he said he was able to take the leap because there was a plan B. His wife's professional occupation could sustain the family and his three children if politics did not work out for him. Faizal Manap and many other candidates did not have the luxury of that choice. For some, the decision to climb the mountain of politics in the adverse political climate of Singapore was a lot steeper than it was for others. And in the final analysis, it was a climb that could only be conquered with the full backing of one's spouse and family members. Faizal's decision was a calling, similar to that of many who join and believe in the Workers' Party and the importance of a strong political opposition in Singapore. In the aftermath of GE 2011, many new faces joined the party, particularly those in their early 20s. Yudish and Ping have been an important part of WP60. Yudish represents a generation of party activists, committed, determined, thoughtful, and most of all, hardworking. I will not take away Daniel's opportunity to speak of all the people behind the anniversary book, of which Ping was a critical team member, but suffice to say the book would not have been possible without them. The post-GE 2011 era was also marked by some election candidates who continued volunteering and supporting the party in spite of their own busy schedules. L. Soma Sundaram, a Temasek Polytechnic lecturer and candidate for Jalan Besar GRC in 2011, organizes the Deepavali celebrations for the Aljunied Constituency Committee every year. Coincidentally, this year's Deepavali celebrations will be held tomorrow in the Serangoon ward of Aljunied GRC. The commitment of the individual we have spoken about did not only manifest when there was something to be done or there was a task at hand. As opposed to new challenges, primarily in the aftermath of the Auditor General Office's audit of the then Aljunied Haugang Punggol East Town Council, and shortly thereafter the 2050 general elections, many members, volunteers and supporters closed ranks and slogged through the tough times with the party in the trenches. They did not let their shoulders drop or lose focus, or worse, fall victim to finger-pointing and self-recrimination. They were aware that self-doubt and internal dissent was the holy grail for detractors of the party, and precisely the outcome opponents of the party sought to engender. Instead, these individuals I spoke about simply persevered with steely determination, even as doubts were cast about their resolve to build a better Singapore through the Workers' Party. For all the people I have spoken about today, and the many, many more that I have not, as much as WP60 is a story of the party's walk with Singapore, WP60 is also about our members, volunteers, supporters through the years, and their energy, commitment and sacrifice, something which goes unnoticed many a time. WP60 is also a small acknowledgement of their sense of mission, which is to build a better Singapore with the Workers' Party as the tool to build a rational, responsible and respectable brand of opposition politics. With all people and supporters of all races and religions, we look forward to walking with Singapore through thick and thin, no matter what the challenge, in the many more years to come. To conclude, and on a much lighter note, I mentioned at the beginning of my speech that the WP60 committee resolved to give its subcommittees and task groups as much latitude as possible in coming up with ideas to commemorate WP60. One rather creative idea was to make inquiries about whether the Workers' Party could send a contingent to march at this year's National Day Parade. The response that came from the NDP organising committee was that there was an overwhelming response from over 30 social organisations and ours was not selected. When we asked what was the selection criteria and eligibility to march at the NDP, we were told that this was confidential. The WP60 committee decided to leave the matter there, but as part of the WP60 anniversary book research, a little historical gem was unearthed. Apparently, Mr. J.B. Jayaratnam had also asked the government if the Workers' Party could be represented by a marching contingent at the National Day Parade shortly after he became MP for Anson in 1981. The government replied formally with then Senior Parliamentary Secretary for Defence, Mr. Pua Ba Lee, stating that any opposition party seeking to march at the National Day Parade would need to have at least 15% of the seats in Parliament before it would be allowed to do so. If the government sticks to its word, it looks like we still have some way to go yet. But with your support and the fortitude and resilience of those who came before us, and those among you who we work alongside with as members, volunteers and supporters, we can get there one day. But only if we remember why we serve. For a better Singapore, for Singaporeans, and not for personal glory or ambition. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful dinner. Thank you.